What's up, I'm travel photographer Brendan Vance of brendansadventures.com, and today I'm going to take you through the various Adobe photo editing software and help you decide which one is right for you. So if you're fairly new to the photo editing world, you might be wondering which of these Adobe products is right for you. So what I'm going to do today is I'm basically going to walk you through each of them, through Lightroom, through Photoshop, and through Photoshop Elements, and I'm going to explain the differences between each of those programs to you. I'm also going to talk to you a little bit about the Adobe Creative Cloud Photography Program, which is a great tool for professional photographers and for people that are just trying to bump their game a little bit from the Photoshop Elements world. So I'll take you through that a little bit and explain it later on as well. But for now, let's go inside and I'll show you these programs. Okay, so first let's take a look at Photoshop Elements. Now, some people might call Photoshop Elements a cheaper version of Photoshop, but me personally, I think the word lighter is probably a better word. There's not a whole lot in my daily photo editing workload that I can't do in Photoshop Elements that I might be able to do elsewhere. So really, lighter is probably a better word. Now, when I started taking photos, actually for probably my first 3 or 4 years, the only photo editing tool I used was Photoshop Elements. So obviously, it is completely possible to do your workload in Photoshop Elements. You're probably wondering what type of person might use Photoshop Elements. Now, I think there's actually quite a wide range of people. For example, if you're new into photo editing and you need a little bit of a guided example on how to go about doing your editing, it's a great piece of software because it really helps you get through the stages and guides you along on how to do your edits without needing a whole lot of knowledge on the process like you might need for Photoshop. Photoshop Elements is also a great product for people that like doing do-it-yourself projects. So if you like doing things like photo books, if you like doing things like creating slideshows or building calendars and that sort of thing, there's a lot of tools integrated into Photoshop Elements that allows you to do that. It's a great program for those types of people. So now let's take a look to see how Photoshop Elements works. So basically, Photoshop Elements is split into two different programs. You've got the organizer and you have the editor. So over in our organizer, you have all your images off in folders. And so I've got a couple images from Central Mongolia here. And you can organize your images by media or by people. If you want to choose the people in your images, you can organize them by people. Or even places, which is awesome if you have GPS tagged images, because it will automatically show up on the map where those photos were taken. And then, of course, events, like if you were shooting a particular wedding or something like that, you can organize it there. And you can do some cool creating within the organizer if you're that DIY person I mentioned earlier. For example, if we select 12 images from Central Mongolia here and head up to create, you can create photo prints, you can build a photo book, a greeting card, you can do a photo calendar, slideshow, collage, instant movie, all sorts of things. So, for example, if we click on photo calendar with these 12 images now, it's going to bring us over to the editor, and it's going to just show us a guided process at editing these photos into a calendar, which is really cool. Now, the editor itself is quite simple, and that's what most people love about Photoshop Elements is you just open an image in the Photoshop Elements editor and it will pop that image over, and then you can choose based on your level of expertise how you want to edit this image. So if you just don't have a lot, you can do quick edits, and then you've got all these things like a smart fix, which will basically do all the work for you. You've got your exposure adjustment, your levels adjustment, your color adjustment here, so you can mess around with your color, your saturation, your hue, your vibrance. You've got your white balance, and you've got your sharpen mode there. In the guided edit, which is what a lot of people really like about Photoshop Elements, it basically guides you through, so it gives you a little bit more control on your edit, but basically lets you do it all, or basically does it all for you. So, for example, let's go into the Enhance Colors menu. And sorry that my computer's a bit slow, but it brings you in here and you've got your auto fix, your hue, your saturation, your lightness, and then you fix it as you want. You hit done. You've got all these things, perfect portrait, color cast, removal, but it's all done in a very quick way and a guided way that helps you if you're not really good with photo editing or it's something you just don't have the time to learn. You've also got things like photo effects, so you can do all these different photo effects, and again, really easy, and it just walks you right through things. And then you've got some fun little photo play things, again, which are awesome for DIY projects. Also, we've got, of course, Expert. Now, Expert kind of has a Photoshop feel to it if you're used to Photoshop, but it's a much, much lighter version. It doesn't have all this stuff up on the side. It's very simple. But you've got your stuff like your clone stamp, and you've got red eye removal, and you can add text, crop, gradients, and you've got all your layers over here the same way as you would in Photoshop. So even though it's a much lighter version, and you can't do everything that you could do in Photoshop, there's a lot that you can get done and is perfect if you're just getting started at learning how to edit photos a little bit more in depth than through the quick or guided versions. And that's Photoshop Elements. So when it comes to Photoshop, there's not a lot I can tell you that you don't already know. Photoshop is the premier photo editing software on the market. Nothing even comes close to Photoshop. Photoshop gives you the ultimate creative control. You can do basically anything to your images that you can ever imagine, and lots of things that you didn't know imagine was possible. It is brilliant. The truth is, though, not a whole lot of my image editing passes through Photoshop. I really only take images through into Photoshop when I'm doing things like blending exposures or doing some really, really heavy editing on a certain photo. Most of my stuff happens in Lightroom. That being said, if you're a designer or you want that really hard edge control of your photo editing, Photoshop is not only the best option, it is probably the only option. It allows you to do things like adding text, adding different layers, throwing multiple exposures together, doing a lot of brushing, and things like that. So just briefly, I'm going to bring you into Photoshop and show you how it works a little bit. So let's go do that. So I've got Photoshop opened here. This is the Creative Cloud version. And as you can see, there is none of this quick or guided or expert. It is all expert, and it's all really kind of difficult to learn if you're a newbie. But the truth is, you can basically YouTube anything. There's instruction videos to do anything you want to do in Photoshop. So I'm going to give you just a quick run through of what it looks like to bring an image into this. And I'll just bring in a raw file from my trip to Gruyere's a couple weeks ago. And if you haven't seen the video from Gruyere's, there's an annotation here for you to check out. So if you want to see the video from Gruyere's, click up there. So this is an image of a lady at the bar, at the Alien Bar in Gruyere's. And first, when you bring a raw image in, it's going to take you to the raw editing processor, which is Camera Raw 8.6 in this version. And I love that you can do that with Photoshop without having to bounce it to a different program to raw process it and then bring it in here. Obviously, if you bring a JPEG in directly, it'll just go straight into the program. But raw files allow you to do some adjustments beforehand. So I'm not going to do anything to this image, maybe just quickly to show you. You can do all your editing here. Whatever you want to do to an image. Like I said, I'm not even really looking at what I'm doing. I'm just clicking buttons to give you an example. So now you're done with this image, you just open it up. And before I go into that, you've also got a lot of processes in Camera Raw, so you can also go and mess with your curves, you can mess with the details, noise, your grayscale, lens correction, effects, etc. But I'm not going to do any of that stuff right now. I'm just going to bring it in here. And as I mentioned, you've got all the same stuff that you had in Photoshop Elements. So over here, you've got your clone stamp, you've got your brushes, you've got your crop tool, you've got, this is your zoom, you've got all the same sort of stuff that you had before, so you don't need to be worried that you're losing anything if you move from Photoshop Elements to Photoshop. You're not losing anything, you are just using them in a different fashion. So your layers all happen over here. And yeah, basically that's it. You've really got to dig into Photoshop Element, to Photoshop. If you want to learn this program, it's best to pick up a Photoshop for Dummies book or something like that. It's also good to go on to YouTube and to search for some tutorials, because Photoshop Element is a bit of a challenge if you're not good at photo editing. It is worth the challenge though, because once you get good at Photoshop, there's a lot of really, really cool stuff you can do with this program. Like I said, it's not only the premier photo editing tool on the internet or on for software, but also for design wise. Any of the YouTube covers that I have, they're all done in Photoshop. It is a design tool, it's an art tool, it's a photo tool. So it is the premier tool, and it's hard to live without it as a professional photographer. The addition of Lightroom into the photo editing world was a major revelation. It really changed the way a lot of photographers did their workflow. It sped things up immensely as well. I would say that I do about 95% of my total photo editing in Lightroom. It is that quick. If you're like me and you're the type of person that doesn't edit their images really, really hard, then all you really need is Lightroom. You can do absolutely everything in Lightroom. Obviously, there's some things like clone stamping, like blending images, like HDR that you would need to bring in either Photoshop Elements or Photoshop into your process as well, which is why I say about 95% of my workload happens in Lightroom, because I can actually bring images from Lightroom into Photoshop or into Photoshop Elements. They work in conjunction, and that is a beautiful, beautiful thing. Photoshop Elements and Photoshop before. Let's go into Lightroom and I'll show you around a little bit. So Lightroom really works in a cool way. Basically what it does is you're gonna import all your files into their library. And what it does is it doesn't actually import the entire file, obviously. It just brings in an example or a rendered preview. And what you're gonna be doing is you're gonna be editing that preview. And it works really quickly that way. And then once you export the files, it doesn't ruin the original file. It just creates a new file for your rendered images. So I've got all these libraries lined up here with the countries I've been lined up, so I can have these files at easy access. And then if I bring them in, bring one of these images, this is an image from Haiti, into the develop module, I've got all these options to develop it. I've got the exposure, contrast, highlights, all that stuff, clarity, vibrance, saturation, all this stuff that you'd be doing in Photoshop Elements or Photoshop, just really quickly. So if I wanted to adjust the contrast, you just click it and it creates an entire layer for that contrast without having to go through all the process of doing it yourself. If you want to go down and mess with the levels, you can do that. You can mess with your colors down here. You've got split toning if you want to do that. You've got sharpness in here if you're trying to figure out your sharpness. You've got noise reduction. You've got lens correction. You've got effects. And all the good stuff. So really, it is the quickest way to edit your photos. There's no way around it. You can just burn through images if you're doing basic edits on your photos in Lightroom, which is an awesome thing. And as an added bonus, if you're the type of person that shoots a lot of things like weddings, for example, you can create your own presets, or Lightroom has some built in, and you can just apply the presets to all your images or to one image really quickly, so you don't even have to do the entire edit. You can also do things like batch editing, whereas you grab a bunch of images at once, and then you go up to the develop settings and you can paste in or sync the settings so that all the images are edited in the exact same manner, which is really cool. You can even do things like move your images over to black and white and then edit them over there. There's all sorts of things you can do in a basic manner. You've also got some other cool tools up here like your crop tool. You've got spot removal if you're doing things like trying to remove like a spot from your lens. You can visualize the spots to try to find where there might be spots on your sensor. You've got red-eyed reduction. You've got this gradient filter, whereas if I want to maybe change the exposure of this side only, I can do that, or darken it, or whatever you want to do. You can also do things like like create another layer mask and brush it like you would in Photoshop. So again, if I want to just brush around this guy's head, I can do that and just paint it the same way you would in Photoshop using an adjustments brush. So Lightroom is awesome. As I mentioned, about 45% of my workload goes directly through Lightroom. It is that efficient, and it should definitely be a part of your workflow. As I mentioned too, if you want to work in conjunction with one of the other programs, you click on Edit In, and then you can edit it in Adobe Photoshop by clicking there. And what it'll do is it'll create a TIFF file based on your edits here, and then bring it straight into Photoshop, so you can do things in both programs and bounce back and forth, and that's a really nice thing to do. So Photoshop, Lightroom, it's a must. For me, it's an absolute must. It's the one thing you absolutely need in your photo editing stuff. The Creative Cloud Photography Program is a great option for pro photographers or people looking to bump their game, as it doesn't make you choose between one program or the other. Essentially, it gives you access to all the top-level photo editing tools. You get Lightroom and you get Photoshop, as well as some bonus products like Bridge, included in one package for $9.99 per month. So in many ways, it works like leasing a car, but rather than paying a fixed term, you just pay the months you use it. So if you're only going to use the photography program for 1 or 2 months a year, you only pay for those months. And that's a great option for those who maybe just travel once or twice a year and really only need to edit photos 1 or 2 months of the year. So another great benefit to the Creative Cloud Photography Program is access to that Creative Cloud. If you upload your photos to the cloud, you can then view them wherever you want, on your smartphone, on your tablet, on your computer, or even on the website. So another bonus to that is the ability to share your photos with your friends and your families. You can hand them off the link and they can check out their photos online or even download them. So if you're a Photoshop Elements user, you might be wondering if it's time to make the jump up to the Creative Cloud Photography Program. Personally, I think that it's a great option. It gives you a lot more flexibility. It allows you to work with both Lightroom and Photoshop to give you more creative control of your photo editing. On the other hand, if you're one of the Photoshop Elements users that uses Elements for the DIY project aspect of things, you like making things like photo books and slideshows, then Photoshop Elements is probably the best way to go, and you should probably stick with that. I would recommend getting Lightroom as an add-on, though, just to do some quicker photo editing through the processes of Lightroom. Anyways, that's a wrap here today. I hope you learned something about the various Adobe photo editing software. And if you're looking to purchase one of the softwares, I hope I helped you decide on which one of those things. That's it for me here. I want to remind you to subscribe to this channel. There's lots of really cool stuff coming up here photography-wise. I'm in Switzerland at the moment. I'm heading to Iceland, which should be amazing. And then I'm off to North America for something a little bit wintery. So stay tuned. Lots of photography stuff on the channel. I'll catch you next time. Peace.